Hello, class. So today we are actually going to be continuing our look at vertex form by looking at applications. So applications is just a fancy way of saying word problems or real life situations. So the vertex form is really useful because we can just kind of see the vertex by looking at the equation. So we can see what the actual optimal value is. We know if it's a max or a min based on the a value being positive or negative. And we know when that optimal value occurs by looking at the x value of the vertex. So we can answer a lot of really useful questions when we have an equation in vertex form. And for questions that we can't answer, we can do some algebraic manipulation to find those answers as well. So the vertex tells us again the optimal value and when or where it occurs. So this simple example, height, if h equals negative 4.9, bracket t minus 5, all squared, plus 20, where h is the height in meters and t is time in seconds, and it represents the height of a ball over time, what can we conclude? Well, first of all, we can find the vertex. Okay, so the vertex is 5, 20, right? Here's the x value and here's the y value. Or in this case, this would be the t value and this would be the h value because it's independent, dependent. Okay, and our graph opens down. Okay, and that's because a is negative. So if you need to write that, you can because a is negative. So therefore, we basically have something that looks like this, where this is 520, if you like a visual. So that means the maximum height is 20 meters. So it means a maximum height, I should say max height, not just max, of 20 meters. And that happens after 5 seconds. So that's pretty cool that we can determine that just by, sorry, looking at the equation. All right, so let's go to another example. So at a fireworks display, a firework is launched from a height of 2 meters above the ground and reaches a maximum height of 40 meters at a horizontal distance of 10 meters. So let's sketch a graph of this situation. So this axis here is going to show the distance from the launch. So it's actually going to show like a visual representation of this firework. And then this will show the height. Actually, I'm going to call it capital H. So we need to get up to a maximum height of 40. So I went up by 5. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. And I need to go up to, I went up by, you'll see why in a bit, I went up by 2s for my distance. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 20. So we have 0, 2 as our y-intercept because it's launched from 2 meters above the ground. Okay, then we know that 10, 40 is the vertex. Now, why is it 10, 40 and not 40, 10? Well, the maximum height is 40. Remember, our optimal value is always the y value of the vertex, and it happens at a time of 10 meters. This always tells us, the x value always tells us when the optimal value happens. So we go to 10, 40 and graph our. Okay, now this is a huge thing. We can use symmetry to find another point. So if this is 0, 2, and at 10, we move 10 over to get to the vertex, then if we move 10 over again, there should be another coordinate at the same height. Again, because this is 10 away from the axis of symmetry, so there should be a symmetrical one over here. So we know for sure, and don't make this a line, this is a curve, right? We know for sure that our parabola reaches here. we don't really know when it explodes. So this whole section we're not as sure about. I don't think they'd let the firework hit the ground again. It's going to explode somewhere in there. So that's how we can graph it. So let's come up with an equation. Well, we're going to let D represent the horizontal distance in meters and let capital H represent the vertical height in meters. So let's identify the vertex. So the vertex is 10, 40. So we put that into the equation. So H equals A bracket D minus 10 all squared plus 40. So I've put in my appropriate variables that I represented, and I put in the numbers for the vertex where they should be. So now I need to sub in a known coordinate, and I know for sure that 0, 2 is a coordinate. So I can sub in 2 for H and 0 for D. Okay, and now I need to go through the process and solve for A. So negative 10 squared is 100. 2 minus 40 is negative 38. And when I divide both sides by 100, I get that A is equal to negative 0.38. I leave it as a decimal. This is a word problem with height and time, so decimals make more sense. So my equation then is the height is equal to negative 0.38 bracket D minus 10 all squared plus 40. This equation represents the height of the firework when it is D meters away from the launch pad. So now I'm going to use it to solve a few more problems. So the firework continues to travel an additional 1 meter horizontally after it reaches its maximum before it explodes. So that means it's exploding. It's at 1 more meter. So here, that's where it explodes. So they want us to find the height at which that happens. Well, if it travels an additional 1 meter horizontally, then our D value is equal to 11. This is 1 meter past the vertex. Okay, so we want to find the height. So we just sub in D equals 11 into our equation. All right, so this can be put into your calculator exactly as written, and you will get 39.62. Notice that this is just slightly lower than the maximum height of 40, which makes sense in the context. So you can give a nice sentence there. Therefore, the firework explodes at 39.62 meters. At what other horizontal distance is the firework at this same height? Well, using symmetry, we know that it would occur 1 meter before the vertex, as well as 1 meter after the vertex. So 1 meter before the vertex is 9. So it would be at 1 meter before the vertex due to symmetry. Therefore, D equals 9. And how can you test this? Well, you could put 9 into the equation and show that it comes out with the same number, 39.62. Okay, this is a bit more of a challenging example. We need to find out if the firework did not explode when it would have reached the ground. So it would reach the ground when our height is 0. So we know that this is just past 20 meters because at 20 meters, it's 2 using symmetry. So somewhere just past 2 meters, it would have hit the ground. But we need to do some algebraic work to find the actual number. So we're going to take our equation and set it equal to 0. So we want H to be 0. So negative 0.38 bracket D minus 10 all squared plus 40 equals 0. So now we're trying to solve for D. When we solve for d, this gives us the distance, the horizontal distance, when the height is zero. So we just need to move things over systematically. The first thing we move over is the 40. Remember, you're using negative, like reverse bed mass here. The next thing we need to do is divide both sides by negative 0.38. That's very important that you understand that has to occur before the square is dealt with. So this gives us d minus 10 all squared is equal to 105.26. Now, here is the clincher, guys. When you undo a square, you have to take the plus and the minus square root. You might be like, huh, what? What's that? Okay, let me explain. If you know that x squared equals 25, sure, you could just square root both sides and say, okay, x equals 5. But what if x is equal to negative 5? Doesn't that also equal 25? Negative 5 times negative 5 is 25 as well. So when you square root something like this, you have to say it's the plus or minus square root of 25. Both the positive and the negative need to be included. Same thing's happening here. When you undo a square, both square roots have to be considered. So this puts us on two tracks for two different answers. Either d minus 10 equals root 105.26, and we'll solve that, or d minus 10 equals negative root 105.26. Okay, so this, you add the 10 to both sides and you put it into your calculator. Make sure that that's under the square root and this isn't, and you get 20.25 meters. Ding, 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 that looks like the right answer. If you add 10 here, you get the negative 105.26 plus 10, you get negative 0.25. So this is what we call inadmissible. Because it doesn't make sense within the context. We can't have a horizontal distance that's negative. This is really the x-intercept that would occur over here. But this doesn't have any meaning within our context. So we say that it's inadmissible. So our solution then is that if it had kept going, it would have hit the ground 20.25 meters from the launch pad. So therefore, it would have reached the ground 20.25 meters from the launch pad. All right, one more question and then there's some practice for you guys. Find the equation for the parabola with a vertex of 315 that has a y-intercept of 5. So we start with our vertex form equation and we plug in what we know. So we know that our h is equal to 3. Our k is equal to 15 because that's the vertex. And then a y-intercept of 5 is the coordinate y 0, 5. We can sub that all in. So 5 equals a, x minus 3, all squared. Oh, sorry, the x should be 0. 0 minus 3, all squared, plus 15. And now we simply solve for a. 5 equals a. Now you can do this in one step. This is just 3 squared, which is 9. Well, negative 3 squared, but it's 9. Plus 15. Subtract 15 from both sides. And a is equal to negative 10 over 9. In this case, we leave it as a fraction because it's not a word problem and it's not an application. So we leave it as a fraction. And our equation is y equals negative 10 over 9. Bracket x minus 3 all squared plus 15. I have three practice questions now that I invite you to try. This is also about a ball being thrown off the ground. And we are going to assume that it's caught at the same height that it's thrown from, okay? That's an important understanding. So it's thrown from 1 meter off the ground. We're going to assume it's also caught 1 meter off the ground. Okay, so we're gonna write an equation, identify your variables, all that fun stuff. Find when the ball is caught. What is the height 3 seconds after it was thrown? And what is another time it reaches that same height? So I'll be taking this up in the next class, you guys. So give it a try. Thanks for watching. Hope you learned lots.